Welcome all for yet another video, Dr. RS and you, Science of Cosmetics and Personal Care Products. Today, we are in part 48. We will talk about petroleum jelly. What is petroleum jelly? Right? So, part 48, petroleum jelly. It's also called as petrolatum. Okay, petroleum jelly also called as petrolatum. Right? What is petroleum jelly? Okay, petroleum jelly is a byproduct of petroleum refining. With a melting point close to body temperature, it softens upon application and forms a water repellent film, an occlusive film around the applied area, creating an effective barrier against loss of the skin's natural moisture. Also protect the skin from foreign particles or microorganisms that may cause infection. So we have studied this many times. I explained how petroleum jelly acts as a good moisturizer. It seals moisture onto the skin, right? So also protect the skin from foreign particles and microorganisms that cause infection. Petroleum jelly is odorless and colorless, and it has an inherently long shelf life. These qualities makes petrolatum a popular ingredient in skincare products and cosmetics. Let us see the history of petroleum jelly, right? Petroleum jelly and Vaseline. People always associate Vaseline to petroleum jelly. We will see the history of petroleum jelly, how it came to the market, right? The medicinal benefits of petroleum jelly was first identified by an American chemist, Robert Augustus Cheese Bro. Later, he joined with Pons, right? Cheese Bro Pons, that first Cheese Bro, in the year 1859, right? What happened? In Pennsylvania, US, the Cheese Bro Manufacturing Company was a pioneer in the manufacturing of oil products, that is petroleum-based oil. Right? Selling them under the trademarks Luxor. Right? Robert Augustus Cheese Bro was a chemist with the company and was interested in the possibilities of using oil products medicinally. In the oil field, he noticed that workers were applying a sticky substance that had adhered to their drills. Drilling for the oil, no? Drilling the oil. So there was a sticky substance that was adhering to the drills. They were applying that substance to cuts and burns in order to heal them. Okay. The substance was known as rod wax. Cheese Bro set about refining rod wax using heat and filtration until he produced the first petroleum jelly. He named the substance Vaseline, from the German word Wasser means water and the Greek word oleon means oil, in the belief that the substance was formed by the decomposition of water in the earth. What is rod wax? When in the refineries of petroleum refinery, after all the oils of various fractions have been distilled, the residue at the bottom is the petroleum jelly. The residue that is left after distilling all the petroleum oils, it's the petroleum jelly. Okay, that is what these people were applying on the skin to heal the cuts and burns, right? So Cheese Bro patented the refining process in 1868. Refining is achieved by passing the heated raw material through the filters, animal charcoal. So he refined it, and the white version has a stiffer composition. Now, once you refine, usually the petroleum jelly is yellow initially, and by refining you get whiter version. Vaseline itself was patented in America, US patent in 1872, and in Britain in 1877. The next venture was to introduce Vaseline to general public, explaining its benefit, which included treatment of burns, abrasion and chopping, plus its many household uses. At first, the advertising and the distribution of the product was by dispatching salesmen with horses and carts all over America. By 1880, it was said that in America, Chesebro was selling a jar of Vaseline every minute. So in 1880, the product became so valuable that he was selling one jar every minute, right? So this is how the original Vaseline, no? It has a cork plug. It is yellow. If you see in color, it is yellow. And these are all the Vaseline in the 19th century, in late 1885, all those years, right? Vaseline. That's how the Vaseline brand name came into picture. So what is petroleum jelly? Petroleum jelly is the residue left after distilling the oil, the crude oil, no? Chesebro was working in this refinery, and he found that this residue has medicinal benefits. So he refined it and patented the refining process. He branded it as Vaseline, and it was a great success. Right? That is how Vaseline started. But what is Vaseline? Vaseline is petroleum jelly. Vaseline is only the brand name that was first given to petroleum jelly. Right? So historical formula with Vaseline, right? It was in early 20th century, 1901, 1905, or late 19th century, 1895, these formulations. Vaseline cold cream, no? Vaseline 2 pounds, fat almond oil 1 pound, white beeswax 10 ounces, bergamot oil 14 drachms. I think 1 drachm is 1/8 of the fluid ounce, right? 1 fluid ounce is 25.5 ml, and French rose geranium oil and Turkish rose oil 20 drachms. So this is Vaseline cold cream. Vaseline cleansing cream, right? Petrol atom 19%, white mineral oil, paraffin oil 63%, white beeswax 6%, white paraffin wax 11.5%, perfume 0.5%, and rouge, no, paste rouge. Petrol atom 77%, petrol atom United States pharmacopoeia grade, cetyl alcohol 3%, cocoa butter 3%, white beeswax 3%, spermaceti 5%, benzoic acid 0.1%, cosmetic lake, and perfume. This paste rouge was in 1955, right? So this was the formula. In 1876, the Lancet, it's a big journal, published a comment on Vaseline, which it is also called as gelatum petroleum, that is petroleum jelly. Vaseline was totally stable and ideal base to incorporate medicaments and easily applied. That was the highlight of the Lancet publication in 1876. And the first edition of the Extra Pharmacopoeia in 1883 has a monograph, Gelatum Petroleum, and gives one of its synonyms as Vaseline. The brand name itself has all the photocopiers, photocopying machine, we call it Xerox. Xerox is the brand name, but it has become like this. Petroleum jelly, the first branded petroleum jelly is Vaseline. So petroleum jelly people also call it as Vaseline. British Pharmacopoeia lists white and yellow petroleum jelly as soft paraffin. Right. Now, petroleum jelly is a semi-solid, is a mixture of hydrocarbons. This is very important. It's a complex mixture of hydrocarbons. Why petroleum jelly is very, very stable? Because it is a long chain. It's not a short chain, long chain hydrocarbons, right? Long chain hydrocarbons. So it doesn't have any functional groups. It doesn't have an OH alcohol group or an aldehyde group or a ketonic group or an acid group, nothing. It's a plain hydrocarbon, right? It's a long chain hydrocarbon, branched and straight. There are branched chain hydrocarbons and a straight chain hydrocarbon. So based on the fraction, the melting point can vary from 40 to 70 degrees centigrade. It is colorless or has a pale yellow color when not highly distilled, translucent and devoid of taste and smell when pure. It does not oxidize on exposure to the air and is not readily acted by chemical reagents. It's very inert. It is insoluble in water, soluble in organic solvents. Petroleum jelly is in monograph of United States Pharmacopoeia, British Pharmacopoeia, and European Pharmacopoeia, and pharmacopoeias of other countries. Right? Every pharmacopoeia has monograph of petroleum jelly. Petroleum jelly skin benefits. In 2009, Kligman conducted a study with various emollients on animals, right, on the hairless mice. All the emollients were applied on the skin and they were subjected to chronic ultraviolet radiation which can cause tumor. What happened? Petroleum jelly inhibit tumorogenesis by about 95%, and it was the highest compared to all the other emollients. And lanolin was the next, was 54%. So it has, petroleum jelly has skin barrier functions. It prevents chafing of skin, right? When treating diaper rash, support healing of wounds, right? It doesn't allow the wound to dry, and it doesn't allow the infection to happen on wounds, right? It protects the wounds and it that way support healing the wounds. Eczema, dry skin and eczema, for controlling, this can be used. Pomades are hair preparations for hair conditioning. You can apply, people were applying perfumed petroleum jelly called as pomades for hair, right? And ethnic hair styling preparations, especially in Africa where their hair is very kinky, that is very curly, it's very difficult to manage their hair. So they use lot of Vaseline, petroleum jelly, and just style their hair. So that is in the ethnic hair care styling. So these are the skin barrier function, prevent chafing of skin, treating diaper rash, supporting healing of wounds, managing eczema, used in hair products, ethnic hair styling preparation. And so petroleum jelly currently in the market, no, it is also made with three ingredients, petroleum ingredients, that's also from the distillate, mineral oil of various viscosities, 75% to 80%, paraffin wax 10% to 15%, and microcrystalline wax 8% to 12%, right? You can play and stabilize it. So microcrystalline wax is more a branch chain hydrocarbon. Paraffin wax is a straight chain hydrocarbon. It's a combination of this, paraffin wax and microcrystalline wax forms a very good petroleum jelly, and it doesn't allow the oil to bleed, meaning the oil at little higher temperature should not come out, no oil oozing out. It will not happen when you use a combination of paraffin wax and microcrystalline wax and with the liquid paraffin to form the jelly. So the most of the jelly currently in the market are made by this route, right? Now the safety of mineral oils and waxes, right? It's always a controversy which has to be addressed. Polycyclic aromatic compounds are the main impurity in petroleum jelly or other liquid paraffins and waxes, no, or petroleum based waxes. So this polycyclic aromatic compounds can cause skin irritation, and there are reports it can cause over a long period of time cause serious problems on dermatological problems. So now there are very highly evolved methods to refine petroleum like mineral oils and petroleum waxes and petroleum jelly to be free from polycyclic aromatic compounds. So when you use petroleum jelly, you have to be very careful where you are buying from, right? It has to be a standard brand that you are buying. And whenever you are using Vaseline for your products also, buy from a standard supplier who has a certificate on the, see here, the most important thing, this is USFDA and USP specification of petroleum jelly. Of course, description, color, acidity and alkalinity, the melting point, all those things are okay. But here, this is very, very important. Polynuclear, there is a detailed method given in USP to determine polycyclic aromatic compounds. So this is very, very important, the absence of polycyclic aromatic compounds, hydrocarbons or polycyclic aromatic compounds, right? So now this, another simple method, no? Any petroleum oil or petroleum jelly, you keep it in a UV chamber, in a glass bottle, in a UV chamber for 8 hours, and then remove it and then cool it and then smell, right? If polycyclic aromatic compounds are present even at ppm level, you can see that the color is changing and there is a pungent smell coming out on UV exposure. So that is one test you can do, and this is a very laborious test, polyaromatic compounds. And whenever you get petroleum jelly from the market or any petroleum products, you have to ensure that it is free from polynuclear aromatic hydrocarbons. Now there are refining techniques which remove this, right? And there was also a controversy on dermal penetration of mineral oils and waxes. Okay, so now there is a paper published in Toxicology Letters, no, volume 288, 5th October 2017, page 7077, review of data on dermal penetration of mineral oils and waxes used in cosmetic application. These are the authors. So what they have concluded, upon dermal exposure, mineral oil and waxes are predominantly absorbed to the stratum corneum only, the outermost layer. Only a minor fraction of mineral oil and waxes reaches the deeper layer of the skin. There is no evidence that mineral oils or waxes as used in cosmetic applications are percutaneously absorbed. The cosmetic use of mineral oils and waxes does not present a risk to consumers due to lack of systemic exposure. So this is what they have published, right? So petroleum jelly, I want to conclude saying petroleum jelly, history may repeat with petroleum jelly back as a leading ingredient in personal care products. Thank you for listening to me in this session. Till I get connected in the next session, bye to you all. Keep smiling, be happy, be safe. Thank you. Bye.